Okay, lastly, I want to set up a GP380, and this GP380 is a special radio. It's going to be the supervisor's radio, and it's going to be the radio which will be able to send emergency exit, stun, and unstun. So you can see that it's a very powerful radio. It will also be able to decode and display PTTID. So let me start off with the GP380 default code plug. So for this radio, I'm going to need three sequences. Sequence 1 will be used for emergency exit. Sequence 2 will be used for stun. And unstun will be sequence 3. Similarly, I need 3 telegrams. So telegram 1 will send sequence 1, and we expect an acknowledge. Telegram 2 will send sequence 2, and we expect an acknowledge. Telegram 3 will send sequence 3, and we expect an acknowledge. Let's look at the decoders. We need effectively 2 decoders. Decoder 1 will be used to decode and display PTTID. Decoder 2 will be used to decode the AUTAC knowledge. So when decoder 1 receives the PTTID, we don't want it to say any alerts, so all of that must be turned off. No auto reset timer. Let's go look at tying the buttons to encodes. So looking at Select-5 encode under per personality 1. Call 1 will send telegram 1. Call 2 will send telegram 2. And call 3 will send telegram 3. So we actually have 3 calls, each sending their own telegram. Looking at decode, we've got 2 decoders. I need to tick both in this particular personality. Right, the other settings are up to you. Let's go look at per radio button definition. So what I'm going to do in this case now is I'm going to set the top button over here to be call 1, the button underneath the PTT to be call 2, and the button right at the bottom will be call 3. So we press this button to send the emergency exit, we press this button to stun, and that button to unstun. Now, let's go look at the menu item. So we need to give the user access to the contact list, and if we've given them user access to the contact list, we need to be able to let them have contact. So remember, file, import, contact list. Otherwise you'll end up stunning or unstunning the wrong radio. Okay, you don't want that sort of scenario. Right, so we've put in our encoders, we've put in our decoders. Now we have a, let's say, supervisory radio which we can use to send stun, unstun, and emergency exit. So let me save this file on the computer. Oh, I have some problems. Now, let's have a look here. Alright, so on personality 1, the encoder telegram used for call 1 is set to ACK1 expected, but no decoder type is set to ACK1 authorization. Alright, let me go fix that. So, decoder 2 is the decoder that we use for auto acknowledge. So that was wrong. That needs to be that. Then there's a whole bunch of warnings. Prefix and alias exceed the maximum number of display digits. I need to go fix that. Per radio, miscellaneous prefix, and delete that. Right. The encoder telegram used for auto acknowledge 1 shall not expect an auto acknowledge. What it's saying to you is that the encoder telegram used for auto acknowledge 1, it mustn't have an auto acknowledge. So if we look at the encoder telegram used for in auto acknowledge 1, we're using encode telegram 1. Okay, 1 is saying that we should send telegram 1. And if we look at telegram 1, encoded telegram 1, that one over there, it says ACK 1 is expected. So in this particular case, in this very specific scenario, in this very specific case, we can choose to ignore that warning and that warning. Remember, these are warnings, they're not errors. So if you had an error, you wouldn't be able to program the radio. If you've got a warning, you can program the radio. But remember, some of the consequences of you programming may not be exactly what you desired. So just be careful about the warnings. But it doesn't mean you cannot program the radio. So I click OK. I click on Save. And I'm going to call it the Supervisor Radio.